Let's journey back to 1843 in Arunachal Pradesh, where the Singpo tribe migrating from Myanmar bravely opposed British rule in Assam. This tale of relentless rebellion and unyielding spirit is a hidden gem in India's storied history of resistance. Arunachal Pradesh lies to the extreme east of India and is the largest of all the northeastern states. Historically, the state was a part of Assam and was inhabited by a large number of tribes like the Adi, Apatani, Nokte, Khamti, Wancho, Nishi, etc. During the medieval times, the Motok Kingdom was in power in the present Upper Assam area, and just next to it lay the country of the Singpos. The Singpo country was bounded on the north by the Lohit River and on the south by the Patkai Range. They are Shan in race, which means that they originated from the present country of Myanmar. 1790s. When Assam was under King Gorinath Sinha, the Singpos drove away the Khamtis and settled at Namrup. All of these were possible because the Ahom king was facing an internal revolt at that time. The Singpos, in fact, joined hands with the rebels and succeeded in captivating a large number of Ahom subjects and took them to their kingdom. The Singpo tribe began to have some loose political relations with the British since the Moamoria rebellion. The Singpos were fighting with the Moamoria rebels against the Ahom power. It automatically brought them against the British, who had come to Assam to assist the Ahom king Gorinath Sinha. 1820s. The discovery of tea bushes in the Singpo region brought the tribe in direct contact with the British. Consequently, their loose political relation had transformed into commercial relation. The Singpo chief Besagam was credited to be the person who introduced tea bushes to the British officer Robert Bruce. Thus, the British realized the commercial importance of the tribe. Apart from this, the British realized that the Singpo homestead was situated in between Assam and Myanmar, thus providing the tribe a strategic importance. This created the establishment of a friendly atmosphere between the Singpo and the British administration in the course of time. 1825. During the Burmese occupation of the Brahmaputra Valley, the Singpos took side of the Burmese and made constant raids on the helpless Assamese, carrying away many more thousands as slaves. They attacked and shut up the Ahom governor at Hodia and then attacked the Bara Senapati at the Motok Kingdom. Both appealed to the British, who sent help to them instantly. At this juncture, the Burmese again launched an invasion on the Patkai and the Singpos again sided with them. The British branded the Singpo tribe as a warlike tribe. This could be substantiated by the words of John M. Kosh. He quoted, "By far the most powerful and the most formidable of these hill tribes are the Singpos." Captain John Bryan Newville at once advanced with an army up to the Noa Dihing, and after a series of assaults forced the Burmese to make their final exit from Assam. He also compelled the Singpos to submit. During these operations, Captain Newville released no less than 3,000 Assamese from the Singpo captivity. They made a settlement with the Singpo chiefs that they would not commit any aggression on the British territory and assist the British whenever it is required. Now, 16 out of 28 Singpo chiefs accepted these terms. The remaining 12 continued to carry on raids on territories of chiefs who had surrendered to the British. Such raids continued throughout the 1830s. In 1843, there was a general uprising of the Singpos, in which all the Singpo chiefs led by Besagam, including those who had entered into negotiations with the British earlier, took part. The main cause of this rising was British encroachment on the Singpo territories. They were helped by Wakung Khunjun from Awa in Myanmar. Captain Newville lost no time in marching troops against the rebels. The operations dragged on for months. Though the Singpo troop was badly defeated, they were not ready to accept British domination and continued to revolt against the British. However, the Singpo troop were badly crippled, thus they could not continue their resistance widely and effectively. though they continued to exhibit their hostility to the British rule, but were being suppressed by the British military troops. Conclusion. The Singpo Uprising of 1843 is a lesser known but important anti-British rebellion. Originating from Myanmar and settling in Assam, the Singpos resisted British encroachment of their land. Despite being subdued by the British troops, the Singpos' continued resistance highlighted their strong opposition to the British rule. This rebellion shows the fierce spirit of the region's tribes against colonial domination.